Culture of bacteria. A microbiological culture is a method of multiplying microbial organisms by letting them reproduce in a predetermined culture media under controlled laboratory conditions. A culture helps us to obtain definitive identification and characterization of bacteria, grow and isolate all bacteria present in an infection, determine which bacteria is most likely causing infection and which bacteria is likely a contaminant or colonizer, to test antimicrobial susceptibility, to stock bacterial strains for further use. Inoculation of culture media. Examine prepared media immediately before inoculation. Look for evidence of contamination, uneven filling or bubbles on surface of agar, color changes, hemolysis, and signs of dehydration such as shrinking and cracking. Discard any defective plates or tubes. When inoculating or seeding a culture media, an aseptic technique must always be used. This will prevent contamination of cultures and specimens, prevent infection of the laboratory worker and the environment. Aseptic techniques. Wear protective clothing, wash hands after handling infected material, and never mouth pipette, eat, drink, or smoke in the laboratory. Flame to sterilize wire loops, straight wires, and metal forceps before and after use. Flame the necks of specimen bottles, culture bottles, and tubes after removing and before replacing caps or plugs. When inoculating, do not let the tops or caps of bottles and tubes touch an unsterile surface. This can be avoided by holding the top or cap in the hand. Always use racks to hold tubes and bottles containing specimens or culture media. Make slight preparations from specimens after inoculating the culture media. Decontaminate the workbench before starting the day's work and after finishing. Use a safety cabinet when working with hazardous pathogens. Culture methods. The various culture methods that are used in a basic microbiology laboratory are streak culture, lawn culture, stroke culture, stap culture, liquid culture, and anaerobic culture methods. In this section, we will only deal with aerobic culture methods. As mentioned earlier, before beginning the inoculation, make sure to follow aseptic technique. Certain other general considerations are: air currents should be reduced to the minimum by closing windows and doors and restricting the movement of people in the room. During inoculation, culture media should be uncovered for only a few seconds. The inoculation of media in petri dishes is referred to as plating out. It is not necessary to use whole plates of media for every specimen. Half or even a third of a plate can be used, especially when using selective media. The area of medium used must be adequately used to give separate colonies. Before inoculating a plate of culture medium, check if the surface of the medium is dry. Moist surfaces will not yield single colonies. If the surface is wet, the plate is kept inverted, resting it on the lid to ensure proper drying. Usually, 30 to 40 minutes incubation at 35 to 37 degrees centigrade is sufficient to dry the surface of an agar plate. For a right-handed person, the Bunsen burner and the inoculating instruments should be placed on the right, and cultures and media should be placed to the back and left. Uninoculated plates, plate cultures, and patient's specimens should be kept with the lids touching the bench and the plate with the media on the top. The caps and plugs of bottles and tubes should be loosened for easy removal while inoculating. Media to be inoculated should be labeled with a glass marking pen or pencil or self-adhesive label indicating the lab number of the specimen and date. Labeling should be done on the bottom of the petri dishes and on tubes or bottles rather than the lids or caps, because there is always a chance of misplacing the lids or caps. Labels should be checked again at the time of inoculation. During inoculation, the right hand holding the inoculating instrument charged with the culture material should be moved as little as possible, and the media should be brought closer with the left hand. Let's begin with the first culture method, streak culture. This method is used to inoculate solid medium in a plate or petri dish, and the objective is to obtain isolated colonies of the bacterium. All the general precautions while inoculating media are to be followed. Label the base of plate which is to be inoculated before you start the procedure. Loosen the cap or cotton wool plug of the bottle or test tube containing the broth culture. Remove the cap or cotton wool plug of the bottle or test tube with a little finger of your right hand and flame the neck. Load the inoculum onto a sterilized wire loop. Flame the neck of the bottle or test tube and replace the cap or plug. Lift the base of the plate containing the medium in your left hand and hold it using your thumb and middle finger. Spread the inoculum thoroughly over area A. This is called the well inoculum. Re-sterilize the loop and let it cool down. Use the loop to draw 3 or 4 parallel lines from the well inoculum onto the fresh surface of the medium. Again, sterilize the loop and allow it to cool down. Then, draw 3 or 4 parallel lines from the area B onto the fresh surface of the medium. Repeat the process till the surface of the medium is adequately covered, taking care to sterilize the loop after each inoculation. At each step, the inoculum is derived from the most distal part of the immediately preceding strokes. Close the lid of the plate and incubate it overnight at 37 degrees centigrade. Isolated colonies of the bacteria can be observed on the surface of the medium next day. Lawn culture. This culture medium yields a uniform or a carpet-like growth of the bacterium over the surface of the medium. This method is mainly used for antimicrobial susceptibility testing. It may also be used for bacteriophage typing and for the preparation of bacterial antigens and vaccines. Lawn cultures are prepared by flooding the surface of the plate with a liquid suspension of the bacterium. Alternatively, sterile cotton swabs can also be used. This is also the preferred method and will be described here. All the general precautions while inoculating media are to be followed. Label the base of the plate which is to be inoculated before you start the procedure. Loosen the cap or cotton wool plug of the bottle or test tube containing the broth culture. Remove the cap or cotton wool plug of the bottle or test tube with a little finger of your right hand and flame the neck. Load the inoculum onto a sterilized cotton swab. Squeeze out the extra inoculum by pressing the swab to the side of the test tube or bottle. Flame the neck of the bottle or test tube and replace the cap or plug. Lift the base of the plate containing the medium in your left hand and hold it using your thumb and middle finger. Streak the swab all over the surface of the medium thrice, rotating the plate through 60 degrees after each application. When the whole plate is covered with the inoculum, pass the swab around the edge of the medium. Discard the swab in a disinfectant solution. Allow the plate to dry for a few minutes with the lid closed at the room temperature. The antibiotic discs can now be placed on the inoculated plate using sterile forceps, sterile needle tip, or an antibiotic disc dispenser. Incubate the plate overnight at 35 to 37 degrees centigrade and read the results next day. Stroke culture. This method is generally used for inoculating Agar's slants or slopes. It is used for obtaining pure growth for slight agglutination and other diagnostic tests. Take a tube or a bottle with an Agar slant medium and label it before inoculating. Loosen the cotton plug or cap. Remove the cap or cotton wool plug of the bottle or test tube with the broth culture with the little finger of your right hand and flame the neck. Load the inoculum onto a sterilized wire loop. Hold the Agar slant medium in your left hand and remove the cotton plug or cap of the Agar slant medium with the little finger of your hand and flame the neck. Then, using the loaded inoculating wire loop, gently streak across the surface of the slant in a zigzag fashion, taking care not to break the agar with the loop. Flame the mouth of the slant again and replace the plug or cap. Sterilize the loop after the inoculation. Incubate the agar slant medium overnight at 35 to 37 degrees centigrade. Stab culture. This method is mainly used to demonstrate gelatin liquefaction, motility, or to study oxygen requirements of bacteria. It is also used to prepare stock cultures. It is performed by puncturing a suitable solid medium with a loaded inoculated wire. Take a tube or bottle with an agar medium and label it before inoculating. Load the inoculum onto a sterilized inoculating wire. Hold the agar medium in your left hand and remove the cotton plug or cap of the agar slant medium with the little finger of your hand and flame the neck. Then, plunge the loaded inoculating wire into the center of the medium in a straight line, taking care to withdraw the wire in the same line to avoid splitting the medium. Flame the mouth of the slant again and replace the plug or cap. Sterilize the wire after the inoculation. Incubate the agar medium upright at 35 to 37 degrees centigrade overnight. Growth is indicated by turbidity of the medium along the line of inoculation. Liquid culture. Liquid media can also be inoculated by a charged loop, pipette, or syringe. The result is commonly known as broth culture. Liquid or broth cultures are prepared for many purposes like inoculating solid media, biochemical tests, water sterility tests, blood cultures, etc. Inoculating liquid medium using a loop is described here. Take any suitable sterile liquid medium like peptone water, BHI broth, etc. and label it before inoculation. Loosen the plug or cap. Keep the specimen or culture plate from which a colony has to be inoculated ready. Sterilize your inoculating loop and allow it to cool down. Remove the lid of the culture plate and pick an isolated colony. Replace the lid. Hold the liquid medium in your left hand and remove the cotton plug or cap with the little finger of your hand and flame the neck. Now, incline the tube or bottle at an angle of 45 degrees and deposit the inoculum on its wall above the surface of the liquid at its lower end. Flame the neck of the tube or bottle and replace the plug or cap. When the tube is turned to its vertical position, the inoculum is well below the surface of the liquid. Sterilize the wire loop before keeping it down. Incubate the liquid medium. Growth is indicated by the turbidity of the medium, unlike the formation of isolated colonies on a solid medium. Subculture. Subculture is a technique by which a new culture of bacteria can be obtained on a fresh medium from an old culture. A few uses of the technique are to yield sufficient number of colonies of bacteria when the primary growth medium has very few colonies. To obtain pure colonies from a medium with mixed growth. To prolong the life of a bacteria by maintaining stock cultures. Subculturing is basically a technique of transferring bacterial colonies from a primary growth medium to a secondary medium. Take a sterile loop and load it with a portion of an isolated colony on the primary medium. Transfer it to a suitable medium by the streak method, which has been described earlier. When making transfers during subcultures, it is advantageous to flame the loop between each set of streaks on the surface of the medium. This avoids over-inoculation and ensures the growth of isolated colonies. Culture of specimens. Urine culture. Urine is cultured for isolation of common agents of urinary tract infection. A measured amount of urine is inoculated onto appropriate media. Use of blood agar and McConkie agar allow detection of most gram-negative bacilli and gram-positive cocci. The urine should be mixed thoroughly before plating. The plates are inoculated using calibrated loops so that number of colonies of bacteria can be counted, which can be further used to calculate the number of viable bacteria per milliliter of urine. This method is called the standard loop method, and usually a loop of calibration 0.01 milliliters is used. Method. Flame a calibrated wire inoculating loop and allow it to cool down. Label the base of plates which need to be inoculated. Mix the urine thoroughly and remove the top of the container. Insert the loop vertically into the urine, allowing the urine to adhere to the loop. Spread the loop full of urine in a straight line onto the middle of the plate. Then, starting from one end of the line, spread the inoculum in a zigzag fashion across the middle line, covering an adequate portion of the surface of the agar. Without reflaming, insert the loop vertically into the urine container again and repeat the procedure for the other plate. Incubate plates for 24 hours at 35 to 37 degrees centigrade. Colony-forming units, or CFUs, are counted on each plate and are multiplied by 100 to determine the number of microorganisms per milliliters of urine. Alternatively, multiply by 1000 if a loop of volume 0.001 milliliters was used. Reincubate the plates with little or no growth for another 24 hours, as antimicrobial treatment might inhibit initial growth. Store the inoculating wire loop in test tubes taped to the wall with the handle down rather than directly on the bench to avoid destroying the calibration. Stool culture. Stool or feces is the commonest specimen examined for the detection of gastrointestinal infections. Bacteria, viruses, yeast, and parasites can all cause such infections. Therefore, it is advantageous to examine stool microscopically first by preparing saline and iodine wet mounts. For culture, a fecal suspension should be prepared for inoculation into different media. Unless the sample is fluid, a portion of solid stool is suspended in 2 to 3 milliliters of phosphate buffered saline or in 0.1% peptone water. Routine culture methods. Specimens received for detection of frequently isolated organisms like Enterobacteriaceae and Salmonella and Shigella species can be plated on a supportive medium like blood agar, a slightly selective medium like McConkie agar, and a moderately selective medium like XLD agar. Blood agar is an excellent general supportive medium as it allows the growth of yeast species, staphylococci and enterococci. A differential or selective medium like McConkie agar will support the growth of most Enterobacteriaceae. all lactose-negative colonies should be tested further, ensuring detection of pathogenic bacteria like Vibrio. Moderatively selective medium like xylene, lysine, desoxycholate agar, or XLD inhibit the growth of most enterobacteria, allowing pathogenic organisms like Salmonella and Shigella to be detected. This medium, along with detection of lactose fermentation, also detects the production of hydrogen sulfide by the formation of black colonies, which is characteristic of some Salmonella species. Enrichment broths. Enrichment broths like Selenite F broth are sometimes used for the enhanced recovery of Salmonella and Shigella species. These broths are inoculated with fecal suspension and incubated in air at 35 degrees centigrade for 6 to 8 hours. Then, several drops from the broth are subcultured to at least 2 selective medium plates. Culture method. Unless the sample is fluid, a portion of solid stool is suspended in 2 to 3 milliliters of phosphate buffered saline or in 0.1% peptone water. Streak method of plating is used to inoculate blood agar, McConkey agar, and one selective medium like XLD if required. All plates are incubated at 35 to 37 degrees centigrade and examined at 24 and 48 hours for suspicious colonies. Sputum culture. The most common specimen used for the detection of lower respiratory tract infections is sputum. Sputum from a bacterial infection is purulent, that is, consisting of pus, contains yellow or green opaque material as well as clear mucoid secretions. Many patients tend to expectorate saliva instead of sputum. Saliva is relatively clear and watery. The laboratory staff should be able to distinguish between a true sputum sample and saliva. Saliva samples should be rejected as culture results of saliva are very misleading. For a good sputum sample, ask the patient to cough deeply and spit the material collected in his throat directly into a sterile container. Tightly screw shut the container and wipe off any spilled material with a tissue moistened with disinfectant. The specimen should be transferred to the laboratory as soon as possible, preferably within 2 hours, as delicate pathogens may not survive for long. Smears for Gram staining and Zedden staining, when required, should be made after the plates have been inoculated to avoid any chances of contamination of specimen. The methods of Gram and Zedden staining have been described in a separate section. Culture method. Material for smear preparation, for staining and culture should be taken from the most purulent portion of the sputum. Blood agar is a good medium to identify most bacterial pathogens. Sometimes, chocolate agar can also be inoculated as it enhances the growth of pneumococcus and haemophilus. The plates should be inoculated using the streak plate method, which has been described before. The plates should be incubated for 24 to 48 hours at 35 to 37 degrees centigrade and then examined. Pus culture. Pus for culture is often submitted to the lab on a swab. As far as possible, swabs should be avoided for sample collection as it tends to dry up the sample and trap the bacteria, which are then not released onto the culture plate. Pus or exudate should be collected in a sterile screw-capped bottle or a firmly stoppered tube or syringe. If, however, a swab is decided to be used, use 2 swabs, one for microscopy and the other for culture. A dry swab should be first moistened with sterile saline or broth and then should be taken through the depths of the wound or lesion to load it with the sample. Always inoculate the plates first and then prepare smears for microscopy. Culture method. The specimen should be inoculated on 2 plates of blood agar, one for incubation at 37 degrees centigrade aerobically, and the other for incubation anaerobically in nitrogen or hydrogen plus 5 to 10% carbon dioxide. It should also be plated on McConkie agar and incubated aerobically. If the specimen is obtained on swabs, it should be first inoculated on blood agar and then onto McConkie agar. Streak method of plating, which has been described earlier, should be followed. The culture plates are examined after an overnight incubation at 37 degrees centigrade. If there is no growth on the plates, they should be re-incubated for another 24 hours. If there is still no growth, the plates can be discarded unless there is a suspicion of presence of some slow-growing organisms like actinomyces, in which case it should be incubated for 7 days.